Amen.
KSA says, KSA.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus.
To break every
power in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Worship. I want to take a few minutes and just visit with you and tell you what a joy it has been for Purpose to be with you today. You all have treated us like family, and that's just, well, Pastor, we don't get that everywhere that we go.
Come on, bro. I understand.
Your hospitality is second to none, and I appreciate you so much just extending your hands to us and making us one of you. We certainly hope this isn't the last time that we get to come here.
Come on, it won't be.
I feel like we've got lifelong friends here tonight.
Yeah.
I visited with some of you enough to know today that you ain't wrapped too tight either. We might be family.
Come on, we might be. I hear you, brother. Pretty close kin, anyway.
I ain't calling no names or nothing. But walks like a duck, quacks like a duck.
Come on.
Might be a little crazy. Just saying. Y'all have been so kind to us today, and I thank you so very, very much for that, for just allowing us to be us. I'm going to tell you something. We go to some big, big venues. You won't have one-tenth of the people willing to testify like you have in this church
today. Yes.
Amen. Praise God.
I was blown away. The Bible says we're made overcomers by the word of our testimony.
Yeah, my blood is yours.
Let me tell you what you're doing by testifying. You were serving notice on the devil that you should have killed me when you had a chance.
Yes.
You should have put me out when you had a chance.
Yes.
But I'm still here, and I'm still alive and well.
Still
standing. God is still on the throne. There's still room for a miracle in my life.
Go ahead, brother.
He should have killed me when he had a chance.
Yeah.
But I'm still here. I dare some of you to look at him tonight and just say, I'm still here.
Yeah. Still standing.
I'm still here to testify of his goodness and his mercy. Let me tell you something, darling. I believe just as sure as I'm on this stage tonight, God's got a miracle for you, Aaron.
Yeah. Come on. Yeah. Glory to God. Yeah.
He's still opening blinded eyes.
Yeah.
He's still healing the lame and letting them walk again. He's still raising the dead. Hallelujah. My God.
Glory.
Hey, this is what the Bible says. This is what the Bible says. As your faith is, so be it unto you.
Yeah.
Whatever that you have need of, you can have it before you leave here tonight. We're only limited by our faith in God. It's not limited his ability, but our faith. As your faith is, so be it unto you. You have not because you ask not.
Come on.
My God. Woo! Hallelujah. Oh, my God, I love what I'm feeling this house. Hallelujah. If you're visiting with us tonight, we don't act like this all the time, but we're working on it.
Amen. Come on.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thrilled to know what God is going to be doing in this church. I am thrilled to know. I want to hear the reports. I want you to be in contact with me and tell me what God has done. And I listen, don't shortchange me.
Come on.
I need it. You tell me what's going on here. Sister Yvonne, I've just fell in love with you today. I thank you so much for just treating me just like family. Y'all have just been so good to us. As I promised earlier today, my daughter did not come in tonight, but that's okay.
Amen, brother.
When we were talking on the bus and Paula made mention in our devotion time, she said, but if it's not today, we don't quit.
Amen.
Watering the seed. It will burst through the earth's crust. And when it does, that vine will bear fruit. And it's going to be good fruit. My mother is here tonight. I want y'all to meet her before we leave. In just a few minutes, I'm going to have her up here singing. And you will see she's holding that little precious. Look at that little fat thing. It's everything I can do to stay up here on stage. That's my grandbaby. That's Adeline Grace. Look at that thing up there. I can't hardly do nothing but that stage. You just wait. If y'all ain't got grandbabies, you just wait. It's going to happen. When you do, you be talking on the tour, and then they get in your face. You be doing that, keep going. You get my baby. And everybody be looking at you like, what's wrong with that child? She don't know. She been knowing Papa crazy. Hallelujah. You don't have to say, Paula, give me a see that. I heard this several times in different people's testimony tonight. And I just want you to say this little chorus with me before we go any further. He is all I need. Sing. They say I Favorite songs that's ever been written. There was a time in my life where I had, well, I testified to you this morning, that when the devil tried to steal my joy, and when I was at a place in my life where as much of the rich heritage that I talked to you about this morning through my parents and my grandparents and my great-grandparents.
Come on!
They couldn't get to me. When I got to a place that I was behind hospital doors and parents weren't allowed there.
Yes.
My children weren't allowed to go back with me.
That's right, brother.
Jesus intervened and went behind hospital doors.
Amen.
There was a time when I didn't know what else to say. You ever been there? You didn't know what else to say? Sometimes you'll find yourself in that place where all you can simply do is just say, Father, I love you. Did I mention how much I love you? Listen to this song.
That I love you. How
song. Do you know how it feels to know something's missing? Hear a small voice that you keep is missing. Do you know how it feels to be troubled inside and to think just for you or to cross someone out? Do you know how it feels when your tears surrender, sins washed away, never to be remembered? I know that trail.
Heaven is real.
We'll tell you something. Y'all are going to be so blessed. She ain't just my mama, but she is the best mama.
Come on.
I know you think you got the best mama, but you don't.
Amen.
Mama in the whole world.
Testify, brother. Testify.
I'll get you. We traveled on the road for many, many, many years. Take off. I'll play. I ain't scared. Don't tell them what we're going to play, but I'll play. In case for those of you that didn't know, I'm going to tell you what's happening. Byron's daughter is being baptized tonight in Tuscaloosa. This is an excellent prayer. It's an excellent prayer of the time served and fasting and nightless days where she's been praying and
fasting
and believing God for her conversion and her coming to the Lord, which she did. And she didn't just get kind of dunked, she got submerged. Hallelujah.
Yeah. And,
when they told me that they were having the baptismal tonight, of course, we were booked here and we promised. I said, Byron, I don't care what I have to do, I'll make a way for you to lead stage and he's going to go FaceTime with her so he can see.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
That's all right, ain't it?
Thank God. Thank God for iPad. Come on.
Glory to God. I'm thrilled to death for him. I'm thrilled just beyond measure.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
All right. For years and years and years, our family sang. They're Bill Williams' family. And my daddy would rather sing than eat.
Come on.
I'm telling y'all, that man would just, he loved to sing. And mom, from the as long as I can remember, as a little boy, I remember mother being over choirs. She always sang. And everybody used to say, your mama sounds just like Vestal. I'd say, no, she don't. She sounds like Missy. That's my mama.
Amen. But Vestal ain't bad, though. Come on.
Well, I like to think that Vestal sounded like my mama.
There you go. There you go.
But that ain't what makes me proud of her. I know this woman. I know the life that she lives.
Yes.
I know her commitment. I know her desire
to
serve God more than anything. You see, my daddy went home to be with the Lord 3 years ago now. And Dad was the patriarch.
Mm-hmm.
But what God spoke to my mother even then, said before Bill Williams ever drew breath, much less been in your life, I was still God then.
Mm-hmm.
And I knew you before he ever knew you. And I still have a work for you to do.
Yep.
I want you to listen. I know she's going to testify. This woman carries a heavy, heavy, heavy anointing. But I just want you to worship with her. I know that I want you to do God Walks the Dark Hills. I want you to listen, Mama, as she sings this song. And I'm going to let her testify and minister to you.
Thank you.
Sis, you're right.
This is what's going to rapture us out of here, folks. And I don't know what a lot of you are going through. I've heard a lot of what God has delivered you from.
Yes.
And I want you to know that he knows what's around every curve and every bend in the road of life.
Yes.
And you don't have to worry.
Amen.
He is ever present with us.
Yes.
And what he's been dealing with me about watching what we say.
Yes.
You know, we have to remember the power of life and death is in this little member's
right.
Amen. And the Bible says that by our words we're condemned, by our words we're justified. We have what we say.
Yes.
And so the Lord had brought me this past week to study the 14th chapter of Numbers. Numbers. And you remember when the Lord had just done one miracle right after another for the children of Israel. But they constantly grumbled and complained. And they had got ready to stone, if you remember, Moses and Aaron. I mean, you know where I'm coming from. This is the second verse, I think it is, in chapter 14 of Numbers. They said, "Would to God that we died back in Egypt." The next word was, "Would to God that we die here in the wilderness."
Come on.
And the Bible says that the Lord said they tempted me ten different times.
Ooh.
And then he said, because of the words that I heard, I'll give them what they desire.
Amen.
They died in the wilderness.
Yes, sir.
This word is a no so. I was looking for a Bible. No, but it is a no so word. Forever, O Lord. Psalms 119:89. Your word is settled in heaven.
Yes.
And heaven and earth, Matthew 24:35, heaven and earth will pass away, but his word will abide.
Amen.
And we can stand. If you've got a need tonight, there's a seed of promise in that word.
Yes, there is.
Just hold on to it. Hold on to it. Hold with your hand. B flat for me, please. B. I'm going to kind of talk this verse off, and something all of you know. If the world from you withholds all its silver and its gold, and you have to get along with meager fare, just remember in his word how he feeds that little bird. Just take your burdens,
of care.